Before getting started on your lab activities, you'll need to learn about the major parts of the light microscope. At the end of part 2, you will be able to name the parts of a light microscope, identify the location of the parts of the microscope, explain how to calculate the total magnification of a specimen, describe how to carry a microscope, and how to prepare microscopes for storage. Many laboratories here at Wake Tech use a light microscope. These microscopes can magnify up to 1,000 times and are perfect for our student laboratories. But before you can use a microscope, you need to know a little bit about the parts of the microscope. So let's start at the top and work our way down. At the top of the microscope are the ocular lenses or eyepieces. These are able to magnify an image 10 times. Also, you will find in the left eye there is a diopter or adjustment ring. This will allow for focusing your eyes when they're slightly different. Inside one of the ocular lenses, you will also see a pointer. This is a helpful tool when you are looking at a specimen under the microscope. As you work your way down the scope, we have the binocular body. The binocular body contains mirrors which will take a single image and split it to both eyes simultaneously. Moving further down the microscope, we see the arm, and attached to it is the entire magnification system for the scope. This system includes the revolving nosepiece, which contains the four objective lenses. The smallest objective lens is the 4x lens, which is referred to as the scanning objective. It magnifies the image 4 times its original size and has the largest working distance. Next is the low power objective, which has a magnification of 10x. Next is the high power objective lens, which has a magnification of 40x and a much shorter working distance. Finally, the 100x lens, also known as the oil immersion lens. This lens is only used in our microbiology courses and should not be used in our general biology lab. You should always record the total magnification you are using to view your specimen. To calculate the total magnification for a specimen that you are viewing, multiply the power of the objective lens that you are using by the power of the ocular. In this case, the ocular lens is 10x, so when we are using the 4x objective, the total magnification will be 40 times. Continuing down the microscope, we see the illumination system. Here, there is a stage which will give us a place to put our slide. There are also mechanical stage clips here on top and stage adjustment knobs just beneath the stage. The bottom stage adjustment knob moves the clips from side to side, while the top stage adjustment knob moves stage forward and backward. To place a slide on the stage, bring the stage a little forward. Place the slide down on the stage and squeeze the clips together as you slide the microscope slide all the way to the back and to the left. Then gently release the clips. Beneath the stage is the condenser, which focuses the beam of light on the object. Below the condenser is the iris diaphragm, which controls the amount of light that passes through the stage and onto the specimen itself. At the very bottom is the actual light source and the on-off switch. Now, we will move to the focusing mechanism, which consists of two knobs. The outer knob is the coarse focus knob, and when you turn this knob, the stage moves quite a bit. The coarse adjustment knob is for bringing specimens into focus and should only be used at the lowest magnification. In contrast, the inner knob is the fine focus knob. Notice that you do not see much movement with the stage at all when you turn this fine adjustment knob. The fine focus is used for seeing the specimen with more clarity. In other words, for seeing details. The very bottom of the microscope is called the base. When carrying the microscope, you should always hold the arm and place your other hand underneath the microscope for support. That is all the major parts of a light microscope. Next, complete the Part 2 knowledge check. Good luck!